God's good pleasure to visit the kingdom.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
Let that be to you.
Yes, Lord.
Good pleasure. Good pleasure, all right. Yes, the Lord will give you favor.
Yes, hallelujah.
Amen, but it's got to be a little bit, another twist to it. It's a good pleasure to give you the kingdom.
Yes.
Just doesn't want to just give it to you, but I mean, just, but he's, yeah, it seems like he's excited. He's eager to, he's eager to give you the kingdom.
Yes.
All right, so what is the kingdom? Kingdom of God, the Bible says, Romans 15:14, the kingdom of God is not meat and drink, but it is righteousness, peace, joy in the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
Anybody need any of that?
Yes. Oh, Lord. Yes, Lord.
The kingdom of God is not meat and drink. It's not meeting, but it's righteousness. Amen. Righteousness, peace, joy in the Holy Ghost. Righteousness, peace, joy in the Holy Ghost. Amen. So that's what God's plan is for us. Righteousness, amen. For us to be in right standing with Him, for us to walk in that righteousness.
Yes, hallelujah.
Amen, peace. How many believe that God can give us the peace that passes all understanding?
Yes.
Amen. It's just good to be at peace. Just, amen. Amen. That means that He's concerned about our finances and everything that concerns us, our health.
Yes.
Our mental state, spiritual state, everything that pertains to us. Amen. It's God's good pleasure.
Yes.
Give us the kingdom. Amen. Praise God. So, the thing that enables us to tap into that, is that God wants us to, amen, have some joy. Scream as loud as you can, break whatever is holding you back.
Yes, Lord.
Man, y'all are kind of tapping in on the secret now.
Yes.
The more you open up and let go, the more you get. The greater release you get.
Right? Yes, thank you, Lord.
Man, there's a scripture that says, fear not, all ye lands. Be glad. Rejoice and be glad. The Lord will do great things. Amen. So, victory we want, the peace we want, the rest we want, the blessings we need, all of that, praise God, is contingent upon opening up, letting go, letting God have His praise. Because God can get the praise and the worship out of you, amen, things are going to begin to materialize in your life. Amen. The kingdom of God is not meat and drink, but it's righteousness, but peace, joy in the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
Amen. And it's God's good pleasure to what? Give you the kingdom. Amen. The Bible says it's God's what? Good pleasure. Amen. That's almost as profound as His eyes are running to and fro.
Yes.
It's almost as profound as that.
Yes.
And that shows me that God is just eagerly waiting for somebody, amen, praise God, to give Him the opportunity to pour out His blessings upon you in a real, huge, abundant measure.
Yeah.
Amen. Because it's His good pleasure to give you the kingdom. The kingdom of God is not meat and drink, but it's righteousness, it's peace, what joy in the Holy Ghost. Joy.
joy. God wants us to have what? Joy.
Joy.
That's how you get the promises and the blessings released in your life. Joy.
Yes.
Amen. And when you open up and holler and scream and break that barrier and get that brokenness released, amen, the joy of the Lord will be your what? Strength. Amen. As long as we withhold the joy, withhold the worship, withhold the crying out, amen, and lifting up your voice, as long as we withhold that, amen, praise God, the longer it's going to take for that fullness and that completeness and that, amen, that victory, amen, to be really focused.
That scripture is Romans 14:7.
Okay, read it again. Romans 14:7.
God
is not meat and drink,
but righteousness
and
peace, joy, and
hope. Righteousness is joy in the Holy Spirit. Amen. Anybody, amen, jump up three times? I said, I don't know about this morning. When God said, suppose God said, I don't know about your blessings this morning. If you ain't ready to pay the price.
Yes.
Amen. So who gets if you want to be the boss, you have to pay the cost. Amen. What God got, there's a what cost and price you have to what? Right? You don't ask for much, you just ask for you. If you have to go out and offer the Lord $500, it might be a little problem, but sometimes God said, I can't bless you unless you put down $5,000. That might be a little challenge for some people.
Yeah.
So for Julia, it wouldn't be a problem. Like, what's up?
Yes.
Oh, hallelujah.
Yes.
Praise God. So God said, all that I need from you is what you. Just give me yourself. Without reservation, give me all. Don't hold back nothing. And he said, I won't hold back from you. Amen. Amen. We are marching on the victory. Amen. So how many, the scripture says, this is the victory that overcomes. Amen. Overcome the world, overcome the flesh, overcome the devil, overcome the circumstances.
Yes,
this is the victory that overcomes even our faith. Amen. Every promise in God is yea and amen. Every promise. Every promise. Every promise in Him. Hey! The Bible says these promises are sure. Every seed in every generation. Amen. Praise God. Now I'm going to tell y'all how y'all can, amen, move up a level higher. Amen. Just start, amen, releasing more. You want to jump, jump. You want to holler a little louder and break that barrier. You know, sometimes it's in the, you just go up to a certain point and you just, you know, you just kind of stuck there. Amen. Amen. So David said, Lord, fill my cup. I think that's a song that said, fill my cup and let it what? Overflow. Amen. We just want to give God everything. Everybody would scream. Amen. Give Father. What circumstance would it take for most of us to get so shaken until we'd scream? We would scream out with everything. What would have to happen for us to scream out as loud as we could? I mean, just as loud as you could, with everything you had on the inside, what would have to happen? Y'all over? What could happen to make a person scream out as loud as they could? What would have to happen?
A fear.
A fear?
Fear of something.
Okay, what could it be, a snake?
That's what it would be for me. Brother Al threw a snake on his pew. You kidding? Yes, indeed. You know, better believe it. Yes, indeed. That's waking it up.
All right. Somebody pull a gun on you, threaten your life, whatever it would take for you to scream out and just release everything you have. Amen. Praise God. Just imagine if you would just give the Lord that type of amen release. What would you do? What would you do? Amen. Praise God. All right. So we just want you to continue to meditate your scriptures. All of these scriptures. Y'all should have most of them by now.
Yeah.
Today was Luke 12:32. Romans 8:32. God didn't withhold his own son, but delivered him up for us all. How shall he not with him freely give us all things? Amen. How many know that Jesus is with us now?
Yes.
He's in our hearts, right?
Yes.
Amen. He's not just in heaven. So he's here to release in us everything that he has provided for us. Amen. Let's all stand and thank God for it. Everybody have a testimony? Exhortation?
I have a short exhortation. I was just thinking about our relationship with the Father God. He's given us all things, and that relationship with him, and when we give him all, there is a harmony in that relationship with the Father God. And I was thinking in my mind of a parallel that if we are in a relationship, a marriage relationship or whatever, when there's harmony in the relationship, God is faithful. And when we're in a relationship, if both partners are faithful to each other, there is harmony. But when there is one is not faithful, there is disharmony there. And that's the same as with our relationship with the Father God. We are faithful. When he's faithful, he's always going to be faithful to us.
Yes.
And when we're faithful to him, there's that harmony. It's homogenized, it's mixing, but it's just like a earthly relationship, you know, marriage relationship. When there's faithfulness together, there's harmony. But when one partner decides to do something different, it breaks that. The same with the Father God.
Yes. All right. So give God, if you're in a relationship, each partner, there's something that each one of them has to have. Amen. To maintain that blood harmony. So in relationship with the Lord, there's something that God wants. God wants our what? Heart.
Yes.
Amen. He wants all of us.
Yes.
Amen. He wants that joy, that peace, and all of that. All right, let's all stand. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you today for your grace and submission. We pray. We also want to be praying for this week. We want everybody to reach out, and let's try to get the maximum response this Sunday, because we want to get a breakthrough with people that haven't been here. We want to try to get them here so that there can be a breakthrough among them. Get them in the flow of what we're doing. So we know about the members that, you know, that don't show up for nothing. Amen. So we just want to use our compassion to reach out to them. And I think that our joy will be much more complete when we take what we have received, begin to reach out and try to bring others in to receive the blessings that we have received. So every one of us, I'm going to try to call at least 4 or 5 people. Amen. Praise God. Sunday, we want to have a maximum response. Amen. And we thank God for those that's reaching out and that's calling. Amen. Some were here last night, right? That we reached out to. He said that prayer, whatever y'all did, I don't know how y'all did it last week, but they said that prayer really helped. Amen. So we just gotta do what we gotta do, amen, in order for our joy to be full. Is that right?
Amen.
Father, today as you lead us,
yeah.
We know that you who have begun the good work.
Yeah.
Pray for all members. We pray that the revival will be here, will extend glory to every member, not just to 15 or 20, but to the entire congregation. We pray that you will put something in us that will help us to open the way, pave the way for others to be blessed. By admonishing them, by praying for them, by sharing with them, by calling them, interceding for them, whatever it takes, or that our hearts be turned to those in need, the lost, those that's without, those that's seeking and searching for the power and the anointing of God. Lord, we want them to be blessed just as we are being blessed. Lead and direct, that us, Lord, the eyes of our understanding to be open so that we might understand your plan for us. Your plan for us to be prosperous. For your plan for us, God, is not, to be deprived and at the bottom of the barrel or without, amen, and short of the things that we need. You came that we might have life, and have life, full life. Father, we give you praise and the glory to you, Jesus, for your blessings upon this entire household and those without and those paths that we will cross. Those that have already highly expressed their needs and desire for it. Father, we give you praise and glory now unto you that's able to do exceeding abundantly of all that we can think of ask, according to the power that we have in us. The only wise God, be glory, honor, dominion, and power, both now and forever. Everybody say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Yes, Lord.
Amen.